Hey, this is Gary with SOS Bracelets.
I'm as guilty as anybody. I bought those bracelets, survival bracelets, and they're pretty, and they're crammed full of things. This one looks like a tooth, a saber tooth, and this one has got a real pretty braid. If you like style, that's what you like. Some of them are survival bracelets. Don't you think that if you were gonna go somewhere to survive, you'd pack more than a bracelet? I did. Come on, man. If this is a survival bracelet, I need some cordage. And if it's a survival bracelet, throw in an extra prop for my motor on my boat. Would it hurt you to put a flare in there? Come on. Or some extra ammo? But in all seriousness, 50,000 people a year get lost in the forest. That's how many times that the search and rescue has been deployed. The average search and rescue goes on for about 10 hours. Now in that time, you need to be able to signal for help. That's what these bracelets are for. But there are times, I'm guilty of it, when you let out alone. You need to get one last shot in before dusk and you walk away from camp. All your stuff's at camp and you get lost. Canoeing down a river, you hit a rapid, fall overboard. All your gear goes down the river. Now what are you going to do? You're cold and you're wet. I've seen people get mad and walk away, go for a walk. And they get lost. It's easy to do. We've probably all done it. Fortunately, we found our way back. But there are times, several thousand people a year, they don't find their way back. They are putting out some money to find you. That's why we went with the bracelet that concentrates on your rescue. We want you to be safe. I found the best weave that I could get the most cordage and still be comfortable. Then I found a way that I could take it off the buckle without cutting the cord or sitting there and trying to untie knots. By the time you're done tying knots, I don't want to survive anymore. My fingers hurt. We've put together a pretty good little package. First day is critical. The rule of threes. You can go 3 minutes without breathing, and 3 minutes is all it takes to bleed out. In 3 hours, hypothermia sets in, so you need to get a fire going, maybe a shelter to get out of the sun, and fire to keep you warm if it's that time of season. You can go 3 days without water. I don't know if I could. You can go 3 weeks without food. Again, I don't know if I could. We've got you covered. If you get cut, we've got your 3 minutes. Hopefully you won't bleed out. In 3 hours, you'll have something to help you out. I'll cover what's inside of this bracelet and how to use them in other videos. You can have a fire going, dry your clothes out, signal for help. And if you got to stay the night, you got to stay the night. My grandchild could take this bracelet apart and start a fire in under 5 minutes. I promise you. So could my grandma if she was alive. Anyway, that's it for me. I'll be back with another video to show you what's inside. Thanks for joining.